The Cold War was a history that brought a high development in weapons technology. Be it ballistic missiles, cruise missiles, surface-to-air missiles, or fighter jets. While most of these weapons are from World War II, but, even earlier, it was the Cold War that drove the development of these weapons technologies. During the Cold War, almost every country got its weapons from one of the superpowers, either the USSR, the Union of Soviet Socialist Republics, or the United States. Countries that sided with the US would acquire systems such as the F-16, F-15, M1 Abrahams, and Patriot air defense systems. While nations allied to the USSR bought systems like MiGs and Suhois, T-72 tanks, and S-300 air defense systems. Pakistan and India have no choice. Pakistan was allied with the US, so they acquired F-16s, Stingers, and M-60 pattern tanks. India was allied with the USSR, so it acquired the MiG Su-30 and the T-72 tanks. However, towards the end of the Cold War, both countries, Pakistan and India, began the program to develop their weapons systems. The development of fourth-generation multirole aircraft was part of this program. So, Pakistan and China began to jointly develop a joint fighter aircraft program, which evolved into the JF-17. While India was beginning to develop LCA Tejas. Both aircraft are in service today in their respective countries. So today we are going to compare the capabilities of the Block 3 version of JF-17 and LCA Tejas Mk 1. The JF-17 is a multirole light single-engine fighter, currently in service with the Myanmar, Nigeria, and Pakistan Air Forces. The Tejas is also a light fighter aircraft developed by Indian Aeronautics Limited. The Tejas currently only serve with the Indian Air Force, but it can also be exported to other countries. Both Tejas and JF-17 are made using the block construction process. This means that new technologies can be easily integrated into them. Both fighter jets feature advanced avionics, a three-axis fly-by-wire system, integrated cockpit displays, and helmet-mounted displays. So let's take a close look at every aspect of both planes and compare them thoroughly. Airframe. The JF-17 Block 3 fuselage is made primarily of aluminum alloys, high-strength steel and titanium alloys, and semi-composite materials. To reduce the cross-section of the radar, it has 9 hardpoints, 1 under the fuselage, 2 on the wingtips, and 6 under the wings. The JF-17 can carry a maximum of 3,700 kg of payload. The fuselage of the LCA Tejas is constructed primarily of high-strength steel and aluminum alloy along with some semi-composite materials. The LCA Tejas has 6 hardpoints, with 3 under each wing. It can carry a maximum payload of 3,650 kg. So although JF-17 has 3 more difficult points, the maximum payload capacity of both aircraft is almost the same. So we declare it a draw. Engines. The JF-17 Block 3 uses a WS-13 engine, which is being developed by Guizhou Aircraft Industry Corporation. It gives the JF-17 with afterburners a thrust of 101 kilonewtons. The LCA Tejas uses an F-404 turbofan engine developed by General Electric. The F-404 can give Texas 85 kilonewtons of thrust with afterburning. So the JF-17 Block 3 has a clear advantage over its Indian counterpart, since it has a powerful engine compared to the LCA Tejas. Speed and range. The JF-17 Block 3 can fly at Mach 2.0 or 1,983 kilometers per hour. Its flight range is 3,480 kilometers, while LCA Tejas can fly at a speed of Mach 2.1 or 2,205 kilometers per hour. Its flight range is up to 3,000 kilometers. The LCA Tejas is slightly faster, while the JF-17 has a slightly longer flight range. Since Texas has better speed while JF-17 has better range. So we declared it a tie between them. Radars. The JF-17 Block 3 is equipped with a KLJ-7A. It is an active electronic scanning radar developed by the Nanjing Institute of Technology. The KLJ-7A radar works in 11 different modes. And it uses more than 1,000 transmit and receive modules per second. This makes it very resistant to clogging. The KLJ-7A radar has a range of up to 170 kilometers. It is capable of tracking 15 tiles simultaneously, and you can attack 4 of them at once. The LCA Tejas is equipped with a locally manufactured atomic radar. ATOM is also an active electronically scanned array radar developed by the Indian Defense Research and Development Organization. The UTOM AESA radar has 16 different operating modes, and it uses more than 750 transmit and receive modules per second. It has a range of up to 80 kilometers for a target with a radar cross-section of 1 square meter. You can track 15 tiles at a time and attack 4 of them at once. Thus, the KLJ-7A radar outperforms its Indian counterpart in terms of detection range and anti-jamming capability. Armor. The JF-17 Block 3 is a multi-role aircraft that carries a wide range of weapons including air-to-air missiles, sidewinder missiles, anti-ship missiles, cruise missiles, precision-guided bombs, and nuclear weapons. The Tejas Mk1 was also originally designed as a multi-purpose light aircraft. But currently, its compatibility with carrying weapons is quite limited, because he recently joined the Indian Air Force. Due to LCA Tejas limitations on weapon carrier compatibility, we will only compare their air-to-air armament with air-to-air armament. Armor JF-17. The JF-17 Block 3 carries PL5, PL12, and PL15 air-to-air missiles. PL5. The PL5 is a short-range air-to-air missile with a range of between 500 meters and 18 kilometers. PL12. The PL12 is an advanced medium-range air-to-air missile. It can shoot down any target between 30 and 100 kilometers. It is an active radar that extends beyond the line of sight of an air-to-air missile. The uses a solid rocket motor to propel its trajectory. The PL-12 missile also features a passive search mode to avoid interference and open up aircraft for long-range air-to-air combat. PL-15 missiles. The PL-15 is a very long-range air-to-air missile. The range is between 150 and 250 kilometers. It uses an active radar homing guidance system and can travel as fast as Mach. That means it can travel 4 times faster than the speed of sound. PL-15 uses a solid rocket motor, and it can be guided in the air by the inertial guidance system. The first Chinese Chengdu J-25th generation stealth fighter, the Mighty Dragon, also pilots a PL-15 air-to-air missile. However, it should be noted here that due to the limited range of the KLJ-7A radar, no targets can be shot down beyond 170 kilometers. What is the effective range of the JF-17 radar in air-to-air weapons? The LCA Tejas operates R73, R77, and Astra air-to-air missiles. R73. The R73 is an all-weather, short-range, air-to-air missile. It has a range of up to 30 kilometers. The R73 is powered by a solid rocket fuel engine. And it uses an infrared tracking system. Astra Rocket. The LCA Tejas operates the domestically built Astra air-to-air missile for medium-range BVR operations. The Astra missile has a combat range of up to 100 kilometers. And it's powered by a solid rocket motor. It uses the terminal's active radar guidance system. And it can be guided via a data link or an airborne inertial guidance system. However, the Astra air-to-air missile has yet to be tested in combat. And some Indian defense experts raised concerns about the accuracy and precision of the Astra missile. R-77. The LCA Tejas also operates the R-77 air-to-air missile. The R-77 is also an advanced medium-range air-to-air missile beyond visual range. It has a range of up to 110 kilometers. It is guided by the terminal's active radar and infrared tracking system. It can cruise at Mach 4.1 and is powered by a ramjet rocket engine. So when it comes to air-to-air armament, the JF-17 Block 3 has a distinct advantage over its Indian counterpart. The PL-15 missile in Block 3's inventory almost doubled the range of the Tejas missiles. Conclusion. It's true, it can be argued that the outcome of an air raid depends solely on the pilots who fly these machines. But we also cannot underestimate the capabilities of the aircraft when it comes to the capabilities that the JF-17 Block 3 has surpassed. The LCA Tejas marks one in almost all aspects, although in some characteristics. The Tejas can compete against Block 3 on equal terms, such as target tracking and engagement rate, maximum speed, and maximum payload capacity. But in all other respects, the JF-17 Block 3 outperformed its Indian counterpart. The JF-17 has better radar, a powerful engine, and a better range. And their BVR missiles have almost twice the range of Tejas missiles. So, in terms of capabilities, the JF-17 Block 3 won decisively against the LCA Tejas. We briefly analyze and compare the capabilities of both combat aircraft. Now tell us in the comments which jet you think will perform best during actual flight use and why. That's all for now, take care and have a nice day.